lung diseases are sort of one of the world's leading causes of death, the biggest killers. They also cause loss of life, so that this can be measured in terms of the years of life that are lost, or the years of productive life that are lost. In some individual countries of the European Union, the figures as high as 1 in 6 or even 1 in 5. So lung diseases are major killers. There is quite a large degree of variation, so some countries have mortality rates more than twice those in other European countries. And this is not just a difference between West and East. There are examples of high mortality countries in Western Europe and examples of low mortality countries in Eastern Europe. If we look at the diseases that are most important in contributing to that mortality burden of lung disease, then globally there are four diseases which contribute. So this is the infections, bronchitis and pneumonia, tuberculosis, and then the chronic diseases, so it's COPD and lung cancer. Across the European Union, we estimate about 7% of all hospital admissions are due to respiratory complaints, and quite a large proportion of that is contributed by obstructive lung diseases, so that is COPD and asthma. Of course, asthma doesn't feature very much in the mortality statistics, so it's important that it comes in as a contributor to the healthcare utilisation. We have achieved a significant advance in terms of being able to look at the hospital admissions patterns, at least for the EU countries. It would be really useful if that information could also be available for the non-EU countries, primarily the countries of the former Soviet Union, and we would be then in a position of providing a continent-wide snapshot of the impact on healthcare. But I think we also need a continent-wide snapshot of the impact on patients and their families.